Hi guys, welcome back to another video of Greatest Hack. In this video, you will learn which code editor you should use for web development. I will also tell you how to download and install this code editor. After installation, we will learn how to set up a project and display the output. So let's start this video. So the first code editor that you can use is Notepad++. You can search Notepad++ on Google and open this website, and you can download it from here. And it is very lightweight code editor. If you just want to work with the HTML and CSS, this is good option. Our next code editor is Brackets code editor. You can search like this on Google and open this website brackets.io. Here you can see this download button. You can download and install this application. It is also very good code editor. It has beautiful theme and some useful extensions. Our next code editor is Sublime Text. You can search like this, Sublime Text, and open this website sublimetext.com. Here it is displaying download for Windows. You can click on this button to download this application, or you can click on this link download and it will open this download page, and here it is available for macOS, Windows and Linux. So you can download it on your computer and you can use this Sublime Text editor to write your code. Our next code editor is Atom. You can search Atom code editor on Google. Open this website. This is also very good code editor. It is open source and developed by GitHub. So you can use Atom code editor to write your code and create your website. Our next code editor is Visual Studio Code. Search Visual Studio Code on Google. Open this website code.visualstudio.com. And here you can see download button, download for Windows. If I click on this drop down icon, it is available for macOS and Linux also. This is the best code editor. It has lots of theme and extension that will help you to code faster. If you're planning to work on JavaScript, React or other JavaScript libraries, then I will recommend you to download Visual Studio Code. Now I will download and install this Visual Studio Code step by step, and I will explain you how you can set up your project and preview the output. Let me click on this button to download this. You can see in the bottom left side, we have the Visual Studio Code setup.exe file. We'll click here to install this application. Click on this and next. Again, click on the next. Here, I will select these checkbox also, and let's create the desktop icon also. Then click on next. Then click on install, click on finish. Once you will open the VS Code editor, you will see this screen, and here you can see options, create file, open folder. So you can open any folder in this code editor, or you can open any file, or you can create a new file. And we have these options in this menu. Let's click on this file, and here you can see new text file, new file, and here we have open file and open folder. So if you want to edit the existing file, you can select open file, and if you want to work on the existing folder, you can select open folder. And here we don't have any file or folder. Here I will click on new text file. Now just press Ctrl S, or you can go here and save. So it will ask you to select the folder where you want to save this. So let's create a new folder here called demo, and inside this demo folder I will add the file name index.html. So like this you can create a new file, and here I will add exclamation sign and tab, so we will get the HTML structure. And if we come to the folder demo, and here you can see we have the index.html file. Now just come back, and here let me add one title, welcome to Greatest Hack. And if you want to open this web page, let's come back to the folder and open this HTML file with any web browser. So I will open it with the Google Chrome. So you can see this message, welcome to Greatest Hack. Like this you can preview your website. But right now, if you change anything in the code file, then you have to refresh this website to see the changes. But we have one extension in VS Code that will refresh this web page automatically. So let's close this browser and come back to the code editor. Here we have the extensions. Click here, and in this search box, you can search for live server. Click on the first search result. You can see this icon. And here we have the install button. Just click on this install. So now it is installed. Come back to the HTML file, and here you can right click and you will see this option open with live server. Click on this one. Here we are getting open a folder or workspace. So let's come to this file. Select open folder and select this demo folder. Now we'll click on this index.html file and select open with live server. Now you can see the same web page, and here we have this local server URL. And now if we will change anything in the code file, here we will add welcome to GreatStack YT YouTube and save this code file and come back to the website. You can see it is displaying YT here. It is updating the web page without refreshing the website. So this is how you can download and install the code editor and create your web page. So I hope this video will be helpful for you. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section. Please like and share this video, and also subscribe my channel GreatStack to watch more videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching this video.